Good evening.
Good evening.
And Merry Christmas. I would like to welcome everyone to worship tonight, all of you who are here in person and those of you watching online. I'm Pastor Maggie, and I'm so grateful to be worshiping with all of you on this Christmas Eve. An announcement before we begin. Debbie Klug would like to share that Harley Schmidt passed away and that his funeral was earlier this week. We will hold his wife Beverly and his family in prayer later in this service. And an announcement for those of you who are watching online, you are invited to get a candle ready for later in our service. I invite you all to settle in, to allow yourself a chance to breathe and to center yourself with our Creator and with one another by hearing these words from Luke. Fear not, for I am bringing you good news of great joy for all people. Please stand as you are able. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, the Word made flesh, our life and our salvation. Amen. I invite you to read the opening dialogue responsively. Star of wonder, star of night, star illuminating, holy and bright, into the deepest of the night, holy darkness welcomes the light. The night has become a place of great glory where God's promises were revealed in the Genesis story. The angel said, "Do not be afraid, for I bring good news from what God has made. For unto us the Savior is born, the Messiah, Emmanuel, the Lord." The grace and love of Christ is given for us completely. Yet on this eve of Christ's birth, we confess we struggle to receive him still. God of love incarnate, you promise good news of great joy for all people and call us to be messengers of your peace. We confess that too often we hoard our joy, your resources, and our security. Have mercy on us, where we are self-centered, open our hearts. Where we are reluctant, give us courage. Where we are cynical, restore our trust. Renew us with your grace, and give us again the hope of eternal life in you. Amen. Good news, great joy. In Jesus Christ, the grace of God has appeared. In the name of Jesus, we are forgiven. Sing with joy, for all the ends of the earth shall know the salvation of God. Amen. Let us sing our gathering hymn, O Come All Ye Faithful, number 283.
Thank you.
all sounded awesome. Let us pray. Our wondrous God, we give thanks for this holy night, a time to sing beloved carols of Bethlehem, of shepherds and angels, of Mary and Joseph, and the baby Jesus, our Savior, who on this night became flesh and lived among us, bringing joy to all creation, bringing peace to all the world, and bringing love to every breath. We give thanks for this holy night and for this star of wonder, where Jesus Christ, our Lord, lay under. Amen. Please be seated.
Good evening, and Merry Christmas. Our first reading tonight comes from Isaiah 9, verses 2 through 7. The people who walked in darkness have seen great light. Those who live on a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. You have multiplied the nation. You have increased its joy. They rejoice before you with joy as the harvest has. People exult when dividing plunder. For the yoke of the burden and the bar across the shoulders, the rod of the oppressor, you have broken on as of the day of Midian. For all the boots of the trampling warriors and all the garments rolled in blood shall be burned as fuel for the fire. For a child has been born for us, its son is given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, as he is named Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continuously, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from the time coward and furthermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. This is the word of the Lord. Our second reading comes to us from Titus chapter 2, verses 11 through 14. The grace of God has appeared, bringing salvation to all, training us to renounce impurity and worldly possessions, as in the present age to live lives that are self-controlled, upright, and godly, while we wait for the blessed hope and the manifestation of the glory of our great God, the Savior, Jesus Christ. He is who gave himself for us, that he might reform us from iniquity and purify himself, a people of his own who are zealous for good deeds. This is the word of the Lord.
Please stand as you are able to welcome the gospel.
Alleluia, Lord and Savior, open now your saving word. Let it burn like fire within us, speak until our hearts are stirred. Alleluia, Lord, we sing for that you bring.
The Holy Gospel according to Luke. Glory to you, O Lord. In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David, called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then the angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly, there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors." This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Please be seated, and children can come forward. You can sit on the floor, too, if there's not room on the step. Come on up. You can come on over. You can sit right there on the floor. Merry Christmas, everyone. What are some of your favorite things about Christmas?
The presents.
The presents. I agree with that. Is that what you're going to say, Chloe? Yeah. Oh, eating the cookies. Oh, eating the cookies and eating the ones that Santa leaves behind. I love it. What? Family. Yes, Christmas is a wonderful time to spend time with family.
Baking an apple pie, then
eating it. That sounds wonderful, too. I love it. Anyone else have something they'd like to share about Christmas? All right, so have you seen these around your church or around your house before? Do you know what I have here?
Manger scene.
Yes, a manger scene, or some people call it a nativity. They usually have a ton of people, right? They have, do you know some of the characters that they have in the nativity?
Mary and Joseph.
Mary and Joseph.
I forgot.
You forgot? Who do you think? A teeny little... Yes, baby Jesus. Townsmen. You guys should have this fresh in your head from last Sunday, right? So we have a lot of people in our nativity story because the story is not just about Jesus. The story is about the people who are here to see Jesus and to worship him. And so just like you guys like your Christmas gifts and your Christmas cookies, God has a special Christmas gift that he likes, and it's every single one of you, which is why all of our nativities have so many different people and animals, because God loves all of God's children, and he loves all of the animals of creation. Isn't that pretty cool? That you're also a gift to God and to other people? So this Christmas, can you remember about the nativity? I got you a special gift. In this little envelope, you will find a sticker that has little stickers on it with all of our nativity people. So you can take this home and then you can decorate it however you want. And you can remember that you are special because you are a gift to God. And then you can hang it on your tree and remember that every year. It's pretty cool, huh? Should we give thanks to God for tonight? Let us pray. Dear God, thank you for loving us.
Thank you for
giving us Jesus.
Help us share the gift
of Jesus with everyone. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Okay, just give me a second before you all get up because I don't want anyone to trip over this. And I'll put this away. And then if you guys can come up one person at a time and we'll get you your nativity scene to go home with. Merry Christmas. Sorry. There you go. Merry Christmas, you guys. All look super nice tonight, too, in your Christmas dresses and outfits. I love it. There's plenty, I promise, to go around. Here you go, Louis. There you go. Chloe, there you go. Oh, beautiful dress, too. Here, want to go, Andy? Here you go. Leilani? There you go. You can go on this side. There you go.
Merry Christmas. Thank you. Mm-hmm. Yes. Oh, no. I have plenty. You're welcome. Where is this going? Here we go. There you go. If there were other kids who didn't make it up to the children's servant, I have extras, so I will get you some on the way out.
Thank you.
Let us pray. God of wonder, you are holy. Create a space for holiness in our lives. Usher your spirit in our midst. Infuse your loving presence in our hearts. Calm our minds and bring us peace. Amen. Christmas Eve is here, the most wonderful time of the year. And you are all here. You made it here to worship, despite your long to-do list, the family gatherings you still have to get to, the last-minute gift wrapping, the food that needs to be finished, or, if you're like me, the food that still needs to be started. And yet, you are here, so try your best to let go of all the things that are waiting for you and settle in. Because being here is such a special gift to give yourself as we come together and worship Christ, who is the best gift of all. And wouldn't it be something if that was all Christmas entailed? Coming together in worship, singing Silent Night as we light our candles and dim the lights, and greeting one another with joy and love. And yet, Christmas inevitably brings up a lot of stuff. The expectations, feelings and emotions, memories, traditions, and the lingering sadness from the loved ones that we have lost. Those who we wish that we could hug and hold, but cannot. And yet the miracle of Christmas shines through in the midst of all of those things. And it shines through even when times are hard. You know, like giving birth to a baby in a cold, unsanitary stable. And the miracle of Christmas shines through even when we are afraid. You know, like those shepherds who feared and trembled. Which is why our beloved Christmas story is so very special. Not only does it tell the story of Jesus' birth, but it focuses on all the people. People who were just like you and me, who endured hardships, challenges, and fears. And the miracle of the story is that God is with them, even in the midst of all of the things. Mary and Joseph had just walked 90 miles to be counted by some census, and when they arrived, they couldn't even find a place to stay. Things must have seemed pretty bleak for them. They were definitely far from perfect. And far from perfect, I'm guessing, is what most of us can relate to. We run out of time to do all the things. Something unexpected comes up. Plans change. Loved ones die. Accidents happen. We get sick. We are tired. Or we're running late. But far from perfect is exactly when God breaks in, reminding us we don't need to be perfect or need to perform in order to receive God's love. God is with us always. God can create miracles in the bleakest of circumstances, giving us gifts when we least expect it. The gift of God's grace when we're struggling to keep afloat, the gift of God's peace when we're mourning a loss, the gift of hope when all else seems hopeless, and the gift of joy in strange and unexpected places, like a baby in a manger who also happens to be the savior of the world. And I often wonder why God appeared this way, in flesh, on earth. I have many different ideas and possible answers, but one always seems to shine the brightest. God became human to be
in relationship with us. A relationship that expands beyond the small window when Christ walked the earth. Because God continues to be in relationship with us even thousands of years later. Through Christ becoming human, God knows how to relate to us, to enter into relationship with us, because God knows exactly what it is like to be human. The beauty, the pain, the sorrow, and the joy. God knows you. God sees you. God is with you. This is a sacred relationship, one where you are never alone. And this isn't the only sacred relationship. Many relationships are sacred, in particular, the relationships that are rooted in love and trust. Those relationships are also a gift. People come into our lives and are cherished. They bring meaning to life, and they are meaningful to God. So meaningful, in fact, God decided to become human and become the most vulnerable part of being in relationship, a baby who needed to be tended and cared for and loved. A great gift was given, a gift that has since changed life. And the gifts we give change throughout our lives as well. And no matter what gift you give, the gift of spending time with family and friends, a store-bought present, a homemade present, a loving embrace. All gifts are shared in the presence of God's love. And an integral part of gift-giving is receiving. Receiving others and the many gifts that flow from God's love. This is what makes the world go round. Our gifts, which were first given to us, in Christ. And the best part of this gift is that you don't need to do anything. You don't need to be extravagant or strive for perfection. All you need to do is be the person you are. And while this is true, it also doesn't mean that things are going to be easy. Like we heard in our gospel today, life, even for Mary, of all people, was filled with times of struggle, fear, and unknown. Because no matter how much we would like things to be easy, it's just not how the world works. Jesus didn't come to give us comfortable lives. Instead, he understands the discomfort and is present with us in those times. Jesus came to be in relationship with us, which in turn gives meaning to our lives. Meaning that we share with others through our relationships and by giving grace. As Anne Boskamp says, grace is the best Christmas gift we always get to give to those who think differently than us, to those who are our neighbors, our enemies, our families. We get grace this Christmas, and we get to give grace this Christmas. Grace isn't a soft, feeble gift, but the most robust, transformative gift of all. When we give and receive grace, God's grace transforms our hearts so that you can fully share your gifts with the world. As a popular saying goes, yesterday is history, tomorrow is a mystery. And today is a gift. That's why they call it the present. This Christmas, may you be present in the midst of all the Christmas presents, because the greatest gift has already been given. Everything is taken care of, and Christmas Eve is here. Amen. I invite you to sing our hymn of the day, It Came Upon the Midnight Clear, number 282. please stand as you are able while we confess our faith with the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate from the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and became truly human. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again. Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who was and the Son is worshiped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. With wonder and joy for Christ coming into the world, we pray for the church, the life of the earth, and the whole human family, responding to God of grace with Hear Our Prayer. God of wonder, your infinite love is born to us this night. With choirs of angels, the church proclaims the good news. Send us out as messengers of hope, proclaimers of joy, and conduits of your love. God of grace, Creator God, you are pleased to dwell with your creatures, and the whole earth sings for joy. Renew the splendor of creation from the smallest cell to the widest galaxies. Guide us to be wise stewards of your gifts for the sake of generations to come. God of grace, abiding God, we rejoice in your company. Give us calm and patient hearts as we gather this holiday season with family and friends. Keep us mindful of those for whom the season is not happy. Console the grieving and surround them with loving support. Be with all who are traveling this holiday season and keep them safe. God of grace, eternal God, we lift up Beverly Schmidt and all who are mourning the loss of Harley. Provide them space to grieve. Embrace them in your loving comfort and peace. May all find peace knowing that Harley is with you and that you are holding him in your loving embrace. God of grace, mothering God, we give thanks that you constantly seek us out. Help us to be present with our loved ones and with you. Open our eyes, hearts, minds, and spirits to receive your gifts of grace, love, peace, and hope. Inspire us to share the good news of great joy of Christ's birth and Christ's love with all whom we meet. God of grace, holy God, comfort your people with tender words of love and healing. Surround all who are grieving, all who suffer with depression or anxiety, all who are injured, any who feel lonely or forgotten. Be a steadfast presence when all else feels uncertain. Today we especially pray for all who are struggling this cold and flu season, and also for Armand Linsmeyer, Maynard Mathey, Jill Kors, Chevy Teske, John Rocco, Mike Hoffman, Annie Ormont, Jim Klinger, Peggy Orvez, Carol and Don Prochnow, Thea Heil, and Carol Fitzke. God of grace, loving God, we pray for all members of St. John and all who pass through our doors. Build up this congregation in Christ. Guide us to stand in our community emboldened with your love. Today we pray for this week's prayer ministry. Jean Barr, Breck Ormont, Justin Zahn, Tom Marquardt, Mitch Landreth, Aiden Ormont, Rhett Schindler, David Spangler, Charlie Knobloch, John Ormont, Emily Moots, and Barbara Leffen. God of grace,
Pondering the mystery of eternal love made flesh in Jesus Christ, we commend all for whom we pray to the mercy of you, our God and our Creator. Amen. May the peace of Christ be with you always. I invite you all to share the peace however you feel comfortable. At this time of year, the abundance of some and the needs of many stand in marked contrast. May Christ's heart rejoice and the needs of others be tended to through our offering. Please stand as you are able while we sing, "Let the Vineyards Be Fruitful."
Thank you.
Let us pray. God of all goodness, by your merciful hand, abundance springs up from the earth. Receive and bless these gifts. May they be a sign of your steadfast love and faithfulness for all people. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ. In the wonder and mystery of the Word made flesh, you have opened the eyes of faith to a new and radiant vision of your glory, that beholding the God made visible, we may be drawn to the love, the God for whom we cannot see. And so with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn.
Holy, holy, holy.
In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks and broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it to all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray how Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated. We'll have continuous communion tonight. We will start by communing both sides, so we'll commune the front two pew, or the front pew first, and then the ushers will usher you forward, where you will receive the bread and the wine on your side. And then after we are done with communion in here, we will go to the overflow area, and the ushers will usher you up for communion out there. There are gluten-free wafers available upon request. And since it is cold and flu season, there is hand sanitizer for your convenience. If you're sitting in the church in a pew, the hand sanitizer, there's one bottle on the inside of the pew, so if you can share with those who are in your pew. If you're in the overflow, there's some on a black stool over there. At the back of the church, there's one where the bulletins are, and in the narthex, there's one on a table when you walk in. So you should find some for your convenience. And this is Christ's table. All are welcome. On this holy night, may all of our hearts cry out, "Glory to God in the highest," as we come to the table of peace. I now invite our communion assistants forward.
Thank you.
Let us pray. God, our Redeemer, you have fed us at this table with gifts of grace, truth, and life. As you have gathered us in joy, send us forth as your messengers of peace. Make us shine with the good news of your glory, born to us in Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. For those of you watching online, now is your time to gather your candle. For those of you here in the sanctuary, you are invited to please stand as you are able. I will light my candle from the Christ candle, which signifies Christ as the light of the world. Then I will light the acolyte's candles, and we'll go around lighting the end of each person in the pew. And if you could pass your light across the pew, just remember that the lit candle always stays upright, never tilted. We will be singing Silent Night with the lights being dimmed, and we will sing the first verse in German. On the last verse, we will lift our candles high into the air. So I invite the ushers to start the dimming of the lights. It looks like we're almost lit. We're waiting for those in the narthex. All right, Linda, I think we're ready.
Amen.
You all sounded and looked beautiful for that. I invite you to blow out your candles. Some announcements before we end our worship service. In our mailbox are your offering envelopes for 2024. And thank you to Louis Reisman for this beautiful Christmas tree. And thank you to everyone who took time to help decorate our sanctuary and our narthex. It looks absolutely beautiful. This coming Wednesday, December 27th at 6 o'clock is the Christmas Pizza and PJ Party. This is a free event, but please sign up in the narthex so we know how much pizza to get, and all kids are welcome to bring a friend. Are there any other announcements? Then please receive the blessing. May God wrap you in love each night, providing you peace and rest. And while you sleep, may God weave strength and courage into every breath. May you meet the morning with resilient vigor, ready for come what may. And may the light of Christ fill your heart with joy every single day. May the Spirit shine on you with favor, love, and never-ending grace. And may the three in one bless you on this Christmas Eve and in every single place. Amen. Amen. Let us sing our sending hymn, Joy to the World, number 267. Christ, the Savior, is born. Go in peace. Proclaim the good news. Thanks be to God.